Hello, future scientists. Today we will be learning about the rings on a tree and what they represent. Pay close attention because there will be questions at the end. There are three learning objectives that we are going to go over today. By the end of this video, you will want to identify the five types of trees described in the video, evaluate the tree rings and be able to find the age of the tree, and assess the tree rings' widths to determine the climate for that year. Organisms react and adapt to shifts in their surrounding environment. This kind of information can be observed in different ways across organisms. Tree rings can be used to look at climate conditions from past years and fill information where there might have been gaps. Did you know that trees can live a very long life? The oldest tree in America was a bristlecone pine tree in California. That tree lived longer than 4,800 years.
These are five cookie samples from different trees. This is a gray birch, this is a pine, this is an oak tree, this is an ash tree, and this is a little maple tree.
This is a gray birch. You can tell by these little tiny stripes in the bark, and this bark is very flat. The white birch is a more common birch that you see in clusters of three or just singles out in nature.
This is a pine tree because it has flat, irregular bark. You can also tell by the sap that it produces. This is an oak tree because it has vertical cracks with smooth bark in between.
This is an ash tree. You can tell by the intersecting ridges right here, and they almost form a tent-like structure. This maple tree has smooth bark because it is less than 8 to 10 inches in diameter. If you look at this maple tree, it has vertical grooves, and this is what happens when the tree gets wider.
A tree cookie is a horizontal cut from a tree trunk. The space between the two dark lines is equal to one ring. A ring represents 1 year of the tree's life. This means the total amount of rings is equal to the tree's age in years. Let's look at this sample and count the rings together. Starting from the center, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. If there are 24 rings, how old is this tree? Well, it would be 24 years old. If the tree was cut down in 2010 and there are 24 rings on this tree, when was this tree planted? According to the number of rings for this tree, it would have been planted in 1986. Tree cookies are a simple tool for analyzing the rings on a tree.
Why do you need to know the age of a tree? Using this map, scientists are able to understand and evaluate the climate during specific years throughout history.
Have you ever noticed that certain regions of the United States are colder or hotter in temperature and are wetter or drier in humidity? How do you think this affects trees' growth? While tree rings do not just tell us the age of the tree, they also show how the climate of their environment impacts their growth. For example, a pine tree growing in Utah, a cold and dry environment, would grow differently than a pine tree in Virginia, where it is warm and humid.
We can see the changes in growth by looking at the width of the tree rings. A wide tree ring mainly represents a hot and rainy year. A thin tree ring represents a cold and dry year. For example, a tree can be old but very skinny. This is because its environment is cold and dry each year, leading to thin rings.
Hello, future scientists. Are you ready? Because it's time for some questions to test your knowledge. Today you learn how to count the rings on the tree and how those rings tell a story. I encourage you to take a walk outside, find a fallen tree or trunk, and count those rings.